हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हेलो, हेलो, ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून। तो एज यू नो, वी आर शेड्यूल्ड गेट एप्टीट्यूड ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर यू पीपल एंड वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन द एप्टीट्यूड। सो टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ द एप्टीट्यूड इज एलिमेंट्री स्टैटिस्टिक्स। सो दिस इज द टॉपिक ऑन विच वी आर गोइंग टू कंडक्ट द न्यूमेरिकल्स एज वेल एज द बेसिक्स रिलेटेड टू द एलिमेंट्री स्टैटिक्स। ओके, सो एलिमेंट्री स्टैटिक्स इट इज वन ऑफ द वास्ट एरिया इन द मैथमेटिक्स एंड फ्रॉम एलिमेंट्री स्टैटिस्टिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन सम टॉपिक। ओके, विच आर दोज टॉपिक्स एंड वट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर आस्क इन द गेट एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व दोज क्वेश्चन दैट विल सी। ओके, so actually it is one of the simplest topic of the aptitude. Some questions are asked on the basis of elementary statistics in a competitive exam as well as in aptitude test of various companies as well as GATE. Some questions are asked on the basis of elementary statistics. Okay, so it is very interesting to solve the questions of elementary statistics. And those questions are also easy. You can solve the questions very easily if you know the formulas, if you know the basics. Okay, if you know the basics and if you know the formulas related to the elementary statistics, you can solve the questions very easily. As I told you, I am going to focus on one of the topic of elementary statistics, that is nothing but the permutation and combination. Okay, we are going to focus on permutation and combination. It is one of the important topic of GATE, then competitive exam. And if you are applying for the various companies, you have to prepare this permutation and combination thoroughly. Okay, so what is permutation, what is combination, that we'll see. What are the basic formulas related to the permutation and combination, and how to solve the questions on the basis of permutation and combination, that will be. Okay, so let us start. So what is permutation? Permutation means it relates to at the arranging all the members of the set into some sequence or order. that is called as a permutation. So permutation, basically it is nothing but the arrangement. We are arranging the things. Okay, we are arranging the atoms, we are arranging the numbers, we are arranging the alphabet, that is called as a permutation. Whereas the combination is, if I go for the combination, combination is a way of selecting the atoms from a collection such that the order of the selection does not matter. Okay, so these two words are very important, arrangement and selection. Permutation, basically it is nothing but the arrangement. We are arranging the numbers, or we are arranging the alphabet, we are arranging the atoms, whereas the combination means it is nothing but the selection. Okay, it is selection. So whenever there is a word in the problem statement arrangement, go for the permutation. Whenever there is a word selection, go for the combination. Okay, whenever there is a word arrangement, you have to go for the permutation. Whenever there is a word selection, you have to go for the combination. So it is as 10 persons are sitting, so you have to arrange those 10 persons, so you have to go for the permutation. Okay, but if it is as 5 men are there and 6 women are there, from that you have to choose 2 men and 2 women. So we have to choose 2 men and 2 women. So for that purpose, we have to go for the combination. So there is a selection. We are going for the selection over here. And when there is an arrangement, we are going for the permutation. So permutation and combination, these are the mathematical tool. Basically, these mathematical tools are used in probability. Okay. So in research area also, we are using this permutation and combination. So what is the mathematical formula for the permutation, and what is the mathematical formula for the combination, that we'll see. And how we can solve the questions of permutation and combination also, we are going to see. Okay, so this is the definition. In mathematics, permutation relate to the act of arranging all the members of the set into the sum sequence or order. Or combination means it is a way of selecting atoms from the collection such that the order of the selection does not matter. So what is the formula for the permutation? Permutation, it relates to choice of R things from the set of N things without replacement and where the order matters. Okay. Choice of R things, we are going for the choice of R things from the set of N things without replacement or where order does not matter. So this is the formula NPR. We are going for the choice of R things from set of N things, set of N things. NPR is equal to N factorial upon N minus R factorial is the formula. Okay, N factorial upon N minus R factorial. N minus R factorial is the formula. This is the formula we are using for the permutation. Simple example I'll explain you. Let us consider that three alphabets are there, A, B, and C. How many ways are there to arrange these three alphabets? I can write A, B, C. I can write A, C, B. I can write B, A, C. I can write B, C, A. I can go for C, A, B or C, B, A. So these are the six ways to arrange the alphabet. Six ways are there to arrange the alphabet. Three alphabets are there. There are three alphabets, and we are going for the arrangement of these three alphabets. So how you can arrange these three alphabets? So how many ways are there? Such a kind of questions are asked. So six ways are there. Because only three ways are there, so I can write the number of ways to arrange these three alphabet. If 10 alphabets are there, in that case, how to arrange those 10 alphabet? If 10 alphabets are there, in case of 10 alphabet, how to arrange those 10 alphabet? It is the biggest task we have. So in that case, we have to go for the formula, that is permutation. Okay, we have to go for this formula. A, B, C, we are arranging in the different manner. So these are the different manners. Okay, now mathematically you can get these six ways. How do you get these six ways? How many alphabets are there? Three alphabets are there. Okay, and I want to arrange those three alphabets. So N it is equal to 3, R it is equal to 3. So 3P3, we are using this formula, NPR is equal to N factorial upon N minus R factorial. Okay, so N it is equal to 3, R it is equal to 3, so it is 3 factorial upon 3 minus 3, it is 0, 0 factorial it is 1. So what is 3 factorial? 3 factorial is, we can write 3 into 2 into 1. 3 factorial it is 3 into 2 into 1. So how many ways are there? 6 ways are there. See, we are getting the 6 ways mathematically. We are getting the 6 ways mathematically over here. And we are getting the 6 ways analytically over here. So what we have used? We have used the permutation. We have used permutation as a mathematical tool to arrange the three alphabets. Okay, so three alphabets are there. We are arranging the three alphabets. 3P3, it is equal to 3 factorial upon 0 factorial. So 0 factorial, it is 1. 3 into 2 into 1, it is 6 ways. 6 ways are there. In same way, if I go for the combination. So what is the combination? Combination, it is a choice of R things. It is a choice of R things from the set of N things. From the set of N things without replacement and where order does not matter. If I go for the same example, I have three alphabets A, B, and C. And I want to select the two alphabets. Any two alphabets I want to select. Any two alphabets I want to select. So which are those two alphabets? You can select A, B. You can select BC. You can select AC. So these are the three ways to select the two alphabets. Now, because only two alphabets I want to choose, so there are three ways. Analytically, I am calculating. But the same question it is asked. And if 10 alphabets are there, okay, 10 alphabets are there and it is asked to choose any two alphabets. So how many ways are there? So it is difficult to finalize the number of ways. Okay, 10 alphabets are given to you and you have to find out two alphabets. Okay, you have to select the two alphabets. I'll say it is a selection of two alphabets. So out of 10, how to choose two alphabets? How to choose two alphabets? That is the question. So for that purpose, we are going for the combination. Permutation is arrangement and combination means selection. Okay. Now you can get these three ways mathematically also. How you can get these three ways mathematically? So this is the formula. NCR is equal to N factorial upon R factorial into N minus R factorial. Okay. The formula to calculate the two alphabets out of three is NCR is equal to N factorial upon R factorial into N minus R factorial is the formula. Now, what is the value of N? N it is equal to 3. Three alphabets are there. What is the value of R? R it is equal to two alphabets. We have to choose two alphabets, right? We can put the value of N and R in the expression. So N it is equal to 3. NCR, R it is equal to 2, right? So 3 combination 2 is the formula. 3 combination 2 is the formula. So you can put the value of N in this expression. 3 factorial upon 2 factorial into N minus R. 3 minus 2, it is 1 factorial. Okay. Now you can simplify this 3 factorial. Right here we have 3 factorial upon 2 factorial. 1 factorial it is 1. Now 3 factorial it is 3 into 2 into 1 and 2 factorial it is 2 into 1. 2 into 1, it is this will get cancelled. We get the value, it is equal to 3. 3 ways are there. So number of ways are 3. Okay, total number of ways are 3 to select 2 alphabet. Okay, so we are using the mathematical tool combination. This is the formula. NCR is equal to n factorial upon r factorial into n minus r factorial is the formula. Right? So we are choosing the 2 alphabet out of 3. We are choosing the 2 alphabet out of 3. For that purpose, we are using the mathematical tool, that is combination. Okay. So in the problems, such a kind of questions are asked. They are asking you, if alphabets are given to you, arrange those alphabet, or the atoms are given to you. Let us consider that 3 black balls are given and 4 white balls are given. You have to choose 2 black balls and 2 white balls. Okay. In that case, you have to use the mathematical tool combination. Right. Another kind of questions are asked. It is asked to find out. Let us consider that we have to find the committee of 5 members. Okay, we have to form the committee of 5 members, and in that 10 women are there and 10 men are there, and you have to form the committee of 5 members. In that, there should be 3 women and 2 men. So how to select these 3 women and 2 men? So for that purpose, you have to go for the combination. Okay. So permutation and combination, it is a mathematical tool. In that, various types of questions are asked. There are many ways to ask the question on the basis of permutation and combination. So what we have to do, you have to remember this formula, NPR is equal to n factorial upon n minus r factorial, and NCR is equal to n factorial upon r factorial into n minus r factorial. If you remember this formula, you can find out the answer very easily. Okay, so let us go for the first question. How many words can be formed by using the letter of the word ABHI? How many words can be formed from the letter ABHI? So there are 4 alphabets. You have to form the word. So how many ways are there? It is very simple. 4 alphabets are there. Out of 4, you have to choose only one. Okay. 4 alphabets are there. N it is equal to. So which mathematical tool you can use? Permutation. You can use the permutation over here. N it is equal to 4 and R it is equal to 4. Okay. So 4PR it is equal to 4 factorial upon 4 minus 4 factorial, it is 0 factorial. 4 factorial it is what? 4 factorial it is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. It is 24. So 24 ways are there to arrange the alphabet ABHI. Right, 24 ways are there. Total number of ways are 24. So how do you calculate? Because it is asked how many words you can form. Okay, so you have to use the permutation. Remember, whenever the words which are used in the problem statement, like arrangement, number of ways, okay, how many words, right? So such a kind of words are used in the problem statement. In that case, you have to go for the permutation. You have to go for the permutation. Right? So permutation and combination is the mathematical tool in that permutation and combination, it is a mathematical tool. In that, we are arranging and we are selecting. So it is the skill. It is a skill that where to use permutation and where to use combination. Okay, where to use permutation and where to use combination, that is the key. It depends upon your knowledge. How do you apply the permutation and how do you apply the combination? Right? We'll go for next problem. Another question. How many words can be formed by using the letters of the word B-I-H-A-R? So how many words are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five alphabets are there. It is asked to find out how many words you can form. Okay, again the same logic. You have to use the same logic. NPR is equal to N factorial upon N minus R factorial. Right? So the value of N it is equal to 5. R it is equal to 5. Right? Put the value of over here. 5P5 it is equal to 5 factorial upon 5 minus 5 it is 0. So why? What is 5 factorial? 5 factorial it is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 it is 120. So how many ways are there to arrange this alphabet B-I-H-A-R in different ways? It is 120 ways are there to arrange the alphabet. Right? So whenever the alphabets are given to you, so directly you can find out the answer. How do you find out the answer? Let us consider that seven alphabets are there. So what is the answer? It is 7 factorial. Right? If 6 alphabets are there, what is the answer? It is 6 factorial. Right? So these are the ways in which we can arrange the alphabet. These are the ways in which we can arrange the alphabet. Okay. But if you observe here, B-I-H-A-R, these are the 5 alphabet and these 5 alphabets are different. Okay, that's why 120 ways are there to arrange these alphabets, 120 ways. But now another question it is given to you, A-P-P-L-E. A-P-P-L-E, this is another question and it is the same. How many words can be formed by using the letter of the word A-P-P-L-E? How many words you can form with the help of the letter A-P-P-L-E? Again, the same logic. How many alphabets are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means 5 factorial is the answer. 5 factorial is the answer. But P is repeating 2 times. P is repeating 2 times. If any alphabet repeats in the sequence, your sequence also repeat. Okay. Your number of ways also repeats. So A-P-P-L-E. If P is repeating 2 times, so your sequence also repeats. Okay. So what we want? We want the number of ways. We want the different ways. How many words are there? How many words? So we don't want the repetition of the word. Okay. Each word will have the different format. Okay. Will have the different sequence. Right? So A-P-P-L-E, 5 factorial is your answer. 5 factorial is 120. But P is repeating 2 times. So what we have to do, you have to divide by 2 factorial. Why we are dividing it by 2 factorial? Because P is repeating 2 times. So you have to divide it by that much of factorial, 2 factorial. Okay. So 120 divided by 2 factorial it is, 120 divided by 2 factorial it is 60. So how many ways are there? The number of ways are 60. 60 ways are there to arrange the alphabet A-P-P-L-E, but P is repeating 2 times. That's why instead of 120 ways, it is 60. Okay, now another question. This is another question. L-E-A-D-E-R. How many ways the letter L-E-A-D-E-R be arranged? Okay, same logic we have to use. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 factorial is the answer. Okay, but E is repeating 2 times. Right? E is repeating 2 times, so that's why you have to divide it by 2 factorial, right? So 6 factorial upon 2 factorial, that is 6 into 5 into 4 into 3, it is 360 ways are there to arrange the alphabets L, E, A, D, E, R. How many ways are there? 360 ways. Okay. So whenever the questions are asked on the basis of arranging the alphabet, because in competitive exam, in a GATE also, this is the or these kinds of questions are asked, right? In competitive exam, in GATE exam, and in placement drives also, such a kind of questions are asked. So permutation and combination, it is one of the important topic, and it is a vast as far as considering the asking the question on the basis of permutation and combination. There are many ways. Okay, there are many ways to ask the question on the basis of permutation and combination. Right. So another question: in how many ways the letter R U M O U R be arranged? R U M O U R. Again, the same logic. How many ways it is the question? So how many alphabets are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 6 alphabets are there. U is repeating 2 times. Right? R is repeating 2 times. So you have to divide by that much of factorial. The number of alphabets which are repeating by that much of factorial, you have to divide the 6 factorial. Right? So the answer is 6 factorial upon 2 factorial into 2 factorial, it is 180. 180 ways are there to arrange the letters R, U, M, O, U, R, where U is repeating 2 times and R is repeating 2 times. So simple logic is there. Whenever the question it is asked on the basis of arranging the alphabet, just you write the number of ways. The number of ways are 6 factorial. Okay. Directly you can write the number of ways by identifying the number of alphabets. Number of alphabets are 6. 6 alphabets are there. So 6 factorial. U is repeating 2 times. So you have to divide it by 2 factorial. And R is repeating 2 times. So you have to divide it by 2 factorial. So like this, you can perform the simplification. Right. So you get the answer. It is 180. Option number A is correct. Option number A is 180 is the right answer. Okay. Another kind of question which is frequently asked in the aptitude is, in how many different ways can the letter of the word J-U-D-G-E be arranged in such a way that the vowels always come together? Now this is the condition. Vowels come together. We want vowels together. You know vowels? Vowels are A, E, I, O, U. A, E, I, O, U. These are the vowels. Okay. So we want the sequence in a such a manner that in which vowels must come together. Okay. Whenever you are forming the sequence, you should have the group of vowels, right? So how to form the group of vowels together and how many ways are there? So there is a logic to find out the answer for such a kind of question. First of all, you have to identify the vowels. Okay, so we know the vowel, it is A, E, I, O, U. So we have formed the group of U and E. So this is the vowel. This is the vowel. We have formed the group of vowels together. J, U, D, G, E, in that U and E are vowel. U and E are vowel. So we have kept it in the bracket. J, D, G, and in bracket U and E is there. Right? Now, so we have to consider this as a one alphabet. Because we want vowels always come together. So you have to consider this as a one alphabet. So we are considering just a minute. Yeah. we are considering this as a group, right? We are considering this as a group. So U and E is in a one group. So we are considering this as a one alphabet. So how many alphabets are there? J, D, G. And considering U and E as a one group, so we have considered one alphabet. It is number of alphabets are four. Number of alphabets are four, right? So you have to arrange these alphabets. So how to arrange these alphabets? Four factorial is the answer, right? So four factorial are the ways to arrange the four alphabets where U and E are together. U and E are together. But in a group or in a bracket, I can write E and U also. This is also one group. Right? This is also one group, E and U, or you can write U and E also. Okay, so how many ways are there to arrange the vowels together? Two ways are there. Okay, how many ways are there to arrange the vowels together? Two ways are there. Right? So, four factorial are the ways in which we have vowels together. And when you have vowels together, how many ways are there? Two. Two factorial. Actually, it is two factorial, so it is two. So, what we have to do? We have to multiply this 24 into 2. 48 ways are there to arrange the alphabets J, U, D, G, E, where vowels are always together. Where vowels are always together. 48 ways means option number A is correct. Option number A is correct. J, U, D, G, E, in that you have to form the group of vowels. So U and E are the vowels. So what we have done? Initially, we have made the group. So it is in the bracket. So how many alphabets are there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 factorial is the answer. But U and E are together. U and E are together. How many ways are there to arrange these two alphabets? 2 factorial. So 24 into 2, it is 48 ways are there to arrange the alphabets together. Okay? Then, now we'll move towards the combination. Yes, this is one of the simplest questions, and it is asked in aptitude test. There are 35 people in a group. There are 12 school girls, 10 school boys, 5 senior citizens, and 8 babies in the group. The organizer of the group wants to select a school girl or school boy as a leader. How many ways can he do so? How many ways he can do so? So this is simplest question. Analytically, you can find out the answer easily. There are 35 people in the group, 12 school girls, and 10 school boys. 10 school boys. Okay. So it is asked to select school girl or school boy. Whenever the questions are asked on the basis of permutation and combination, if the word it is there or, you have to go for addition. If the word it is there and, you have to go for multiplication. Okay, so here it is word or. So you have to go for addition. Right? 35 people in the group, 12 school girls are there. There are 12 school girls and 10 school boys. What is the condition? The leader should be school girl or school boy. The leader should be school girl or school boy. So from 12 school girls, you have to choose one. And from 10 school boys, you have to choose one. Because only one leader will be there. Only one leader will be there. So you can go for the combination because it is select. You have to select. Okay, so whenever there is a word selection, you have to go for the combination. So you can go for the combination. How you can go for the combination? It is 12 combination 1 and 10 combination 1. Okay, 12 combination 1 and 10 combination 1. 12 are girls, 10 are boys. Out of that, I have to choose one. So one is the leader. So 12 combination 1 and 10 combination 1. And here there is the word or, so that's why addition. Okay, so what is 12 combination 1? 12 combination 1, it is 12. And 10 combination 1, it is 10. So 22 ways are there. 22 ways are there to form a leader from 12 school girls and 10 school boys. Okay, option number A is correct. Okay, now as I told you, there is a formula for the NCR. NCR, it is equal to N factorial upon R factorial into N minus R factorial. This is the formula. Okay, I have written directly here, it is 12. Okay, you'll get 12 over here. You can apply the formula. N it is equal to 12 factorial upon R factorial, it is 1 factorial, and N minus R factorial, it is 11 factorial. Okay, so you can write 12 factorial, it is 12 into 11 factorial. 12 into 11 factorial upon 11 factorial. 11 factorial, 11 factorial get cancelled. What you get, it is 12. Okay, so whenever there is the value of R, it is equal to 1, what you get, it is N. Answer, it is N. If the value of R, it is equal to 1, means 22 combination 1, 22. 30 combination 1, 30. Okay, now we'll go for next. And this is another type of question which is frequently asked in the aptitude. A box contains two white balls, three black balls, and four red balls. In how many ways can three balls be drawn from the box if at least one black ball is to be included in the draw? At least one black ball is to be included in the draw. At least it is mentioned. At least means you must have one black ball. You can go for two black ball, but condition it is at least means there is a one black ball. You can go for three black ball, one black ball is present, like this. Okay, so you have to go for the three balls be drawn, right? And at least one black ball must present. So how many black balls are there? First of all, three black balls are there. Okay, two white balls are there and four red balls are there, right? And you have to form three balls. We need three balls. What is the condition? One black ball must be present. Okay, so we need three balls. One black ball is present. So you have to take two balls from other. Like this, you have to form the three balls. Okay, so how many other balls are there? 2 plus 4, it is 6 balls are there. 6 other balls are there. From that, you have to choose 2. Okay, you can go for 2 black balls. Right, you can go for 2 black balls. Three black balls are there. You can choose 2 black balls because 1 black ball is present in this. At least one black ball must present. So you can choose 2 black balls and one other. Like this, you can choose 3 balls. Or you can choose 3 balls of black and you can choose 0 black balls of other. Like this, you can have the 3 balls. Okay, so if you observe over here, I have one black ball over here. Here I have one black ball. Here also we have one black ball. We are satisfying the condition at least one black ball is present. So this is at least one black ball is present over here. At least one black ball is present. Okay, so you can go for these ways. These are the different ways. Either I can go for one black ball, two other, two black ball, one other, zero black ball, three black ball, zero other. So these are the number of ways to select three balls. Okay, so now whenever there is a selection, you have to go for the combination. Use combination as a mathematical tool. You have to select these two balls from six. You have to select this one ball from three, right? So I have written here mathematically. You can choose the three balls like this, one black ball, two non-black, or you can select the three balls, two black ball, one another other, or you can choose three black balls, right? So because we have to select, so what we are doing, we are going for the mathematical tool, that is combination. 3 combination 1 into 6 combination 2 plus 3 combination 2 into 6 combination 1 plus 3 combination 3. Okay, so whenever there is a word or, you can go for addition, and whenever there is a word and, you can go for multiplication. So just we have written the mathematical statement for the given mathematical analysis. Okay, so we have written the mathematical statement, right? So we are getting 3 combination 1 into 6 combination 2 plus 3 combination 2 into 6 combination 1 plus 3 combination 3. So if you simplify this, you will get 64. Okay, so what do you get? 64. What is 3 combination 1? It is 3. As I told you, if the value of R it is 1, you can write directly 3. Into 6 combination 2, you can apply the formula of NCR, it is equal to N factorial upon N minus R factorial into R factorial. Simple way it is there. There is this one simple way. 6 combination 2, it is there. So what we have to do, we have to decrease this 6 by 2 times. 6 into 5 upon 2 into 1. You'll get the same answer by applying the formula. 6 into 5 upon 2 into 1. What I have done? This is R. R it is 2. So I have decreased this 6 by 2. 6 into 5. And 2, obviously you have to decrease by 2. So 2 into 1. Okay. Plus 3 combination 2. So 3 combination 2, if I go for the formula, it is 3 factorial upon 3 minus 2, it is 1 factorial upon 2 factorial. So what you get, it is 3, right? Or you can go for the mathematical analysis, subtract 2 from 3. So what you get, if I subtract 2 from 3, 3 combination 1 you get. What is 3 combination 1? It is 3 into 6 combination, it is 6, right? Now if I go for this 3 combination 3, it is 3 factorial upon 3 factorial into 0 factorial. 3 factorial, 3 factorial get cancelled, it is 1. So it is 1. Means the value of n and r, it is same. So what is the answer? It is 1. So if you simplify this, what you get? It is 64. 64 is the right answer. So this is one of the important questions. Frequently this question, it is asked in the various aptitude tests. Okay, so 64, option number C is correct. The logic behind such a kind of problem is this word, at least. Okay, at least one black ball is present. So here we have at least one black ball, at least one black ball, at least one black ball is present. Okay, go for next. This is another question which is frequently asked in the aptitude. How many ways can 11 cricket player be chosen out of the batch of 15 players? How many ways can 11 player? You know, in cricket there are 15 members, 15 player. Okay, when we are choosing the player to play on ground, so we are choosing only 11. In a squad we have 15 player, but we are choosing only 11 player to play on ground. Depending upon the performance, depending upon the match to be played, on the basis of this we are choosing 11 player. It may be test match, it may be one day match, or it may be T20. So depending upon that, we are choosing the 11 player out of 15. So how many ways are there? Okay, so you have to choose the number of ways, right? So whenever there is a selection, you have to go for the combination. So how many ways are there? So 15 players are there, you have to choose the 11 number. So 15 combination 11, right? 15 combination 11 is the mathematical analysis we have to do, because we have to choose the 11 player. Okay, go for the formula. It is 15 factorial upon 11 factorial into 15 minus 11, it is 4 factorial. Right? You can simplify this. This is 15 into 14 into 13 into 12 into 11 factorial. 11 factorial upon 11 factorial into 4 factorial. So this 11 factorial, 11 factorial gets cancelled. You can write 4 factorial, it is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. You can simplify this. So you get the answer, it is 1365. 1365 is the right answer. Option number A is correct. Right? Option number A is correct. 1365. Okay. See, now this is, if I perform this mathematical analysis, it will take time. What you have to do? Speed maps, or you should know the trick. What is the trick? Subtract 11 from 15. What you get? 4. Okay. So it is 15 combination 4. I have subtracted 11 from 15. So what we are getting? 4. Okay. So here I'm writing 4. Right. Now what we have to do next? You have to decrease this 15 by 4. Okay, you can decrease. This is 15 into 14 into 13 into 12. We are decreasing it by 4. Next, you can decrease it by 4. 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, we are getting the same analysis. Right? So what is the answer? If I simplify this, 1365. Another question which is most or which is frequently asked is, yes, this is the another question. In a class there are 15 students. During one party, all of them handshake with each other only once. How many handshakes took place? In a class, there are 15 students. And during one party, all of them handshake with each other only once. It is mentioned that it is only once. So how many handshakes took place in the class? So again, because we have to go for the handshake, we have to go for the handshake. So for handshaking, we need 2 students. Okay. At least 2 person we need for the handshake. right? Means it is a question of selecting the two students out of 15. Okay, it is a question of selecting the two students out of 15. That's all. Right. So there are 15 students, and I have to choose two. Right. 15 students are there. I have to choose two. Why? Why two we have to select? Because we have to go for the handshake. Okay. So because we have to go for the handshake, we have to select the two persons. We have to select the two persons. Right. Now, what next? You can go for the formula. Again, if I go for the formula, what we can write it as 15 factorial upon 2 factorial into 13 factorial. Right. So it is 15 into 14 into 13 factorial upon 2 factorial. It is 2. So I'll not write here 2 factorial into 13 factorial. 13 factorial, 13 factorial get cancelled. It is 2, 7, 14. So what is the answer? It is 105. 105 is the answer. Option number A is correct. Option number A is correct. 105 is the right answer. 105 ways are there for the student to go for the handshake. Okay, so how many handshakes took place in the class? It is 105. Okay, I told you the mathematical analysis earlier. Whenever there is a, here we have 2. We can decrease this by 15 into 14 upon 2 into 1. We'll get the right answer. Okay, instead of performing this mathematical analysis, directly you can write, here we have 2, value of R it is 2. So 15 into 14 upon 2 into 1 is the right answer. It is 105 is the right answer. Okay, so 105 handshake took place in the class. 105 handshake took place in the class when there are 15 students. The same question it is asked in the different way. If 15 nations are playing one tournament, so if one is playing with another only once, so how many matches will be done in the tournament? Same answer, 105 matches will be done. Or 15 chess players are playing one tournament. If 15 chess players are playing one tournament, if one is playing with another one, only one, so how many matches will be done? Okay, so in that case also we will have the same answer. It is 105. Right? When the questions are asked on the basis of this is the one question which is related to the handshake, or they may ask you the same question in a different way. As I told you, 15 nations are playing one tournament, 15 players, chess players are playing one tournament. How many matches will be done? In that case, you have to go for the same analysis. 15 combination 1, it is 15 factorial upon 2 factorial into 13 factorial. It is 105. Option number A is correct. Okay, now this is one of the aptitude question. Find number of ways in which four particular person A, B, C, D and six more person can stand in a queue so that A always stand before B, B always stand before C and C always stand before D. Okay, condition it is given to you. Find the number of ways in which four particular person A, B, C, D, but A stand before B, B stand before C, C stand before D, and six more persons are there. So how many ways are there? To arrange these persons. Okay. So find the number of ways in which four particular person A, B, C, D and six more person can stand. It is one kind of arrangement. Okay. How many ways are there to arrange these 10 person it is asked. But the condition it is that A, B, C, D must be in this format. A should be before B, B should be before C, C should be before D and six more persons are there. So I cannot break this sequence. A should be before B, B should be before C, C should be before D. I cannot break this sequence and six more persons are there. So we have to consider this as a one more person, right? One more person. This group you have to consider as a one person and six more persons are there. Okay. So total seven persons are there. So how many ways are there to arrange these seven persons? It is, as I told you have to go for the permutation. The first problem which we have solved on the basis of this, it is 7 factorial. Okay, directly you can write the answer, it is 7 factorial. Option number B is correct. 7 factorial is the right answer. 7 factorial is the right answer. A, B, C, D, I cannot change the sequence. So that's why we have considered this as the one group. And because we have considered this as the one group, and six more persons are there, 1 plus 6, it is 7. 7 persons are there in the group. You have to arrange this 7 persons. Okay. So how many ways are there? 7 factors. So these are the number of ways in which we can arrange the persons. Okay. So these are some problems which are asked on the basis of permutation and combination. These are the different questions which are asked on the basis of permutation and combination. Right? We can go through this, solve more and more questions, and definitely this will be helpful for your placement as well as for your GATE purpose. So today we'll stop here. Okay, so thanks.